Tonight we honor the many parts that make up the one body and sanctify us. During Mass, we offer bread and wine during the presentation of the gifts. These simple gifts symbolize the work of human hands. So, standing here before us are the gifts that each part of sanctify us, offered to make sanctify us who we are. As I call your name, if you would place your offering at the top of the sanctuary. Dorothy Burns, representing bereavement. Jennifer Pokowiak, representing Cub Scouts. Mary Beth Pop, representing evangelization. Rebecca Biskowski, representing Festival Committee. Fran Ristovich, representing Hospitality. Greg Long, representing Human Concerns. Matt Haugen, representing Knights of Columbus. Tom Gallagher, representing Lifelong Faith Formation. Mark Cobble, representing the Parish Council. Audrey Hammer, representing Homebound Ministry and Partners in Prayer Ministry. Kathy Wilkowski, representing RCIA. Kathy and Dave Pascal, representing Respect Life. Millie Schilling, representing Sleeping Bags for the Homeless Ministry. Amy Janice, representing Spiritual Life and Worship. Carol Zeeler, representing Stewardship. Dave Kimmel, representing St. Vincent de Paul. Gary Fox, representing the ushers.
knowing that being with them is coming home. To you, my brother and sister, the Saint Matthias, think of all the people who have called this community home. Think of all the people who are yearning for a place to belong, and they find all are welcome here. James Joyce wrote, "The best definition of Catholicism that I can give you." James Joyce's definition of Catholicism: here comes everybody. And what did we just see walking down the aisle? Everybody. All those people who represent the best of who we are. To build up the church is to build up the body of Christ. The Latin word for body is corpus, from which we get the word corporation. How many of you have worked for a corporation? Now, this is very significant. Abraham Heschel says that our task today is not to return to the catacombs. Our task is to remain holy in the skyscrapers. Our task is the transformation of the world. And we do that not individually, but communally. Paul knew this when he said, "Now you are together the body of Christ, and each of you is a part of it. And in the church, God has appointed for some to be the messengers, others to be the preachers, thirdly, the teachers. After them, God has appointed workers of spiritual power, people with the gift of healing, helping, counseling, and those who have the gifts of speaking in various tongues." As we look at the body of Christ, do we find that all are his messengers? Are all preachers? Are all teachers? Do we find all wielders of power? All able to heal? All able to speak with tongues? All able to interpret tongues? You should set your hearts on the best spiritual gifts, but I will show you the way that surpasses them all. And that becomes his introduction to his sermon on love. Love is patient, love is kind. So St. Paul tells us that we are all gifted. All of us have different gifts, and so that wasn't so beautiful as people walked out. And everybody has found a place in which to serve the people of God and our community by sharing their gifts. Good work, hard work, noble work, sacred work, and you all do it so well. I like particularly the can koozie. Are you a party church? I have a sneaking suspicion that outside of Lent you are. We are the church, gathered and scattered. Repeat that. We are the church, gathered and scattered. And as our work, our task, that God has given you and I to make the world a better place. God loves goodness more than God loves perfection. God created a perfect world that God had intended to. But God created a world that is good, with human beings very good. But goodness only happens if you and I together are committed to making God visible in the world. We are the people of God, and we have been invited into a covenant relationship with God, who says to all of us, "I will be your God, you will be my people." We belong to God, and we belong to each other. Think about just a moment. Some of you have been worshiping together for over 40 years, and before that, your families worshiped here. Think about it, as each of these people walked up front, you knew something about each of them. Isn't it amazing that in the church how well we know each other? say interview. Okay. Future father-in-law sat down across the table from future son-in-law and said, "Say, tell me, what kind of job do you have?" "Well, I don't have a job that God provided." "I see. Where are you going to live after you got married? You got a place to live?" "No, except what God provided." "All right. Do you have any money saved up? You know, things can come up in marriage. Do you have any money?" "No, we don't have any money, but God provided." "All right." So I went downtown to have some coffee and scratch. I said, "How's that new son-in-law going to be?" "Oh, he seems to be a fine fellow, but he thinks I'm God."
Thank you.
my responsibility to love you. We are a community. Whether we're having a good day, whether our souls are enlarged and we are compassionate and thoughtful, or whether we're having one of those days in which the world is kind of turned in, we continue to have a responsibility to love each other. Parker Palmer writes this: in a true community, we will not choose our companions, for our choices are so often limited by self-serving motives. Instead, our companions will be given to us by grace. Often they will be persons who will upset our settled views of ourselves and our world. In fact, we might define true community as the place where the person you least want to live with always lives. Let me repeat that. Community is that place where the person you least want to live with always lives. Here comes everybody. This is what grace is. This is who you are every time you say, all are welcome in this place. It's extraordinary. Now, audience participation. Talk to the person next to you. Kind of raise up your hand. Raise up your hand. Raise your hand. Praise Jesus. Praise Jesus. Oh, no. All right. Now, we're not going to ask you to do it, but the first right next to you, we have to talk about training. The strongest finger on our hand, digit, is our thumb. Talk with each other. What is a gift or a strength that you bring to this community? Talk with each other. What is a gift or a strength that you bring to this community? Our ring finger is our weakness. writes the people that are closest to you. This finger is good, gives you direction, so always pray for your teachers. These are the people that stand out in your life. Pray for your elders and the leaders in your life. Pray for strength to deal with your weaknesses. And then finally, pray for yourself and so very precious in the eyes of God. Now, why is that important? Why did I have you talk with each other? Class? Why did God make you? Together? Okay, we went to different grade schools. Why did God make us? To know, love, and serve God in this world and next. Know, love, and serve our neighbor. That's ourselves. How is it that we can know each other if we don't talk with each other? You know what we find happening today? Why is it that we're split apart? We don't talk to people that don't agree with us. We only talk to people that we like to talk to. Has that ever been the Catholic Church? No. Here comes everybody. Now, if I could share this one nugget with you, I think this is terribly important. I have found it difficult not to like somebody once I know their life story well. Once I've taken a chance to understand how they've lived and suffered, what gives their life meaning, and what they believe in. In the early church, there were only three things that were necessary. Gather the folks, break the bread, and tell the stories. And what were the stories? How God was active in their lives. How it was still difficult to live under Roman rule. How they were having a hard time preparing for their families and didn't know how they could care for their elders. Tell the stories. Talk with each other. Support each other. Love each other. So in the early church, been talking a little in Hebrew, let me give you some four Greek words. This became essence. Pneuma, which is the spirit of Jesus. Pneuma was the spirit of Jesus, was given to the community for the charisma, the gifts. Where do all of our gifts come from? From the Spirit. So people who are taking care of bereavement ministry, you might not have wanted that gift, but God gave it to you. Those of you who have a gift of working in the young and the Boy Scouts, it's critically important. Those of you who have the gift of catechesis, it's a gift that's been given to you. Each and every one of us has gifts that are given to us by Jesus. But the gifts are not for myself. The gifts are not for my honor and glory. My gifts are for the community. I have never seen such a sacred procession in a Catholic church as what I witnessed here tonight. Where our Catholic community understands that we have many gifts in this community. And what's the goal of leadership? It's to unlock those gifts so people begin to share them with each other. And not only while we're here, but we take those gifts to the streets. So this is what it was. Pneuma, charisma, which is the gifts, builds up the koinonia, which is the fellowship, which then you go off for service.